checking them, and check it out. Now, I got a story to tell. Because lost in the context of what people believe they see is context of what actually goes on behind the curtains. Okay, now, in mid-November, okay, I received a frantic phone call, FaceTime call from XXXTentacion. He basically was hella mad. He said, yo, academics, these pussy niggas just jump me in. And while he was swearing a million miles per minute, I was saying, yo, X, calm down. What the fuck are you talking about? And he said, yo, these Migos niggas, man, they jumped me out here in L.A. And I said, yo, what the fuck? Like, how did this happen? He said, I saw them niggas. I saw them lining me up. They rolled up with cars, and I stood there. I never ran. I took them on one by one. I got my ass whipped, kind of, but you know what? I ain't no bitch, and I'm going to go get back mine. Now, the first thing I said, X, what are you doing? Stop, slow down. Okay, by the way, at the same time, I'm getting hella videos on Instagram from people who have recorded X getting pummeled by the Migos, and it seems like it was an entourage or their bodyguards. It wasn't the Migos members themselves. Now, I'm trying to calm this kid down, and I'm like, yo, X, chill. By the way, I was there after the incident with Rob Stone. I talked to him right after. So he, at that point, did listen to my advice under certain circumstances. But you got to realize when a nigga is 19 years of age, okay, he's now experiencing success and he has a hot head, a bad temper. Plus, you mix it with all the things he's gone through in his past where he loves to fight and all of that. He could not be controlled. I said, yo, X, chill. Now, he was on the conversation with me, and as I tried to calm him down and question, why are you out there alone? And he kept saying this to me repeatedly. He says, Ak, I don't need 1,000 people with me everywhere I go. He says, I come out here by myself. I stand on my 10 toes. He says, I don't need an entourage. I'm not pussy. And I tried to remind him that he was not only just a young street nigga who used to pull up on everybody and fight, and those fights would go on the internet and go viral. I said, you're a rap star. Don't work like that. And while he was saying, nah, Ak, you understand. We had that conversation till he looked at me through the FaceTime phone conversation. And he saw himself and he saw that he was bleeding. And the minute he saw he was bleeding, he hung up. You know why? And by the way, I tried to call him back. He didn't answer. He went back outside. I don't know if he went with people or whoever, but that's where we get the infamous liftoff situation because, yeah, he was trying to find them niggas, okay? And he wasn't with no one. Now, I don't mean to bring that up because recently Offset just wished him condolences and said RIP, and that's a dead issue. So I'm really even sorry to have to bring that up, but I have to bring it up in context to say X was someone who did not believe that he needed an entourage of people everywhere he went, or he needed security everywhere he went. Add to the fact that he believed that his home turf of Florida, that he was unilaterally loved. He told me, yeah, because I said, yo, listen, after the first time with the Rob Stone thing, I said, bro, you got to get security. I kept telling him that. You got to get security. And he did take my advice when he went back on tour because, of course, he had some legal issues and venues were really worried about him because of the aftermath of the situation with him and Rob Stone. But essentially, man, he was basically saying, you know what? I'm going to beef up some security on tour. I get it. I'm 100% in agreement with you. So he listened to me there. But he told me, he said, listen, when I get back to Florida, I don't need none of that shit. Okay? And he's pretty much operated like that. Now, I tell you all that to say this. His lawyer, as recently as earlier this week or last week, advised him to get security, okay? Now, of course, in certain circumstances, he would have people around him, but X was the guy who wasn't scared of the people. He wasn't scared of essentially what was coming to him or what dangers were out there. He met them. I remember having a conversation with him, and he said, I don't care about fighting. And I said, yo, we live in a different world. Niggas don't want to fight. This is not when you could just pull up on niggas and have a fist fight. They're going to shoot. And he just was not receptive to that. Now, I don't say that to blame him, but it's really his trust in people and his trust in the place that he resided for 20 years. He never thought he needed security. Okay, so when he is going out to go buy a vehicle and he goes to the bank and allegedly pulls out a large lump sum of cash and has it in a Louis bag, yeah, he still doesn't think he needs security. Because you know why? When fans see him and pass him, yeah, they might be obsessive, but they are showing love and they let him go. He doesn't really come into situations where he has to defend himself on the daily. Not that he wouldn't, but that is not what usually happens. Also, when it came to him going out, like, he would do regular things. He would, as I said, he would pull up to the park, play basketball, or just play with the homies at the park. And not people he knew, just people who knew him. Not knowing what their intention is, not knowing if they're calling their mans to line him up. He wasn't concerned with that, because you know why? He wasn't scared of the people who made him him. Now, a lot of entertainers live in fear. He did not. And sometimes that fear is warranted, and sometimes it's just overly paranoid, but X was pretty laid back. So when these things happen, and if we are to believe the cops that this is a random act of robbery, this is a kid, again, who had faith in humanity and thought that people would not want to take his life. He repeatedly told me, if somebody had a problem and they want to catch a fade, I got no problem with it. I've done that repeatedly. I've done that time and time again. He always said on the internet, I don't do the guns, but I'll always fist fight. And even though he was young and that was the only way he knew how to solve problems at that time. And by the way, he grew by the time he got gunned down 2 days ago. By that time, he was a different person. A person who was able and willing to settle his differences with words, not fists. So I say all that to say, his lawyer advised him to get security. If you think I'm hyping people up, I advise him to get security. But I'm not going to say because he was stubborn, it's because he saw different in people that in the harsh reality of the world, there's evil people out there that, no, they don't just want to beat your ass and keep it moving or just rob you and keep it moving. They want to take your life, and that's permanent. And if that's the situation that made us lose XXXTentacion, it makes everybody, and I see a lot of entertainers now thinking, whoa, maybe I shouldn't go to a certain place alone. Maybe I shouldn't go with only my one friend. Maybe I should invest in some security. Maybe I should make sure I'm rolling correctly. Again, I saw, and we talked about it in length. We had many conversations like this. I told him after the Rob Stone situation, the Migos situation, other situations that I will not speak about. I said, X, you got to roll like a rapper who's on and who's the guy. I'm so sad and sorry that he didn't heed my advice. But even then, who knows if it would have really worked. Again, I look at things different. He would look at me and be like, Ack, you scary, man. Like, he's like, you scary. You don't want to be in certain situations that he wouldn't mind being in those situations because he had a different upbringing and he's been through some realities that I have not been through. Again, who knows if security could have been the thing to save his life? Who knows if more people were there, this wouldn't happen. But we're left today and we're left for the rest of time to kind of just ask ourselves these questions. I ask myself these questions ever since I found out he died in the circumstance. I'm like, damn, who was with him? Damn, where was security? Damn. Yo, it's crazy. Because he really was rolling around in a lot of cases just with his guard down. And it's not that he was like just oblivious to what was going on in life. He just saw the good in people and thought that people wouldn't be trying to take his life. And by the way, for people who try to correlate this to rap beef, he moved better ever since the situation with Rob Stone. Every time, and after the Migos situation, every time that him and another rapper had some type of issue, believe me, he was moving right when those issues were a potential threat. What I'm saying to you guys is that he was at home. He felt Florida, Broward County, was home. He felt he didn't need security at home. He felt he was going to be good at home, and he was loved and revered at home. Unfortunately, he was not. X, we love you, and we wish this wasn't a reality we have to deal with. We wish we could change all the circumstances. We wish we could prevent that situation from happening. And even now, we try to Monday morning quarterback it, and we think about these things. I am not sitting here blaming him in the least bit, because if he wasn't as trustworthy, and if he didn't love the people like the people love him, and if he was scared of the people, he would not have that connection with 10 million fans. He would not. He would not. So it's one of those things that you think about, breaks my heart to even play out situations and try to pinpoint what it could have been. But it's very unfortunate that it was so easy for some scums to just run up on him and take his life. Get in the comment box, make sure you guys like them, subscribe. It's your boy Academics. We're still dealing with this, but we're going to deal with it as a family. Please comment your thoughts.